419, this is a rubber duck. You got a copy on me, Big Ben, come on. Yeah, 10-4, Big Ben, for sure, for sure. By golly, it's clean, clear at Flagtown, come on. Yeah, it's a big 10-4 there, Big Ben. Yeah, we definitely got the front door, good buddy. First thing's alive, looks like we've got us a convoy.
On the 6th of June in a Kenworth on Lowe's. Cab over Pete with a reefer on and a Jimmy hauling hose. We was heading for Bear on I-10 about a mile out of Shaky Town. I says, Big Ben, this here's a rubber duck and I'm about to put the hammer down.
What's going on, YouTube? We are rolling, rolling, rolling. I'm on probably about 500 miles for the day. We're pulling into Laredo now, Laredo, Texas. Just about at the receiver. You already know how we do. Always go to receiver. I stopped at the truck stop, taking a shower, washing my laundry because I didn't do it this weekend. Get out this left lane. We didn't do it this weekend because I went to get my car from North Carolina, so. That didn't work out, but I see we pull into Laredo, just getting to the city limits now. It's a good week, kind of fast, man, kind of fast. But I had to basically run that load in North Carolina, drop it off. The same day I re-hooked up to another trailer because I had to drop the other one and loaded the car and the bike on. I wanted to kind of make a video, but I don't know. I'm gonna leave that alone. So got it all loaded, basically did a turn and burn. I drove 2 hours that night. That's all I had on my clock left, so got as far as I could. And the next day, I don't know what happened. I ran out of my 70. I didn't even realize that was that short of hours. I tell you, running Texas regional is different. Because I truly forget that I have a 70 hour clock. Because I get like usually an extra 20 hours a week. So, like, I've kind of stopped even looking at that clock. That catches up with me is the 14, so that's about it. But besides that, that's about it. I showed up to Dallas yesterday, got in about midnight, had a rollback waiting on me. He got the stuff off for me, and then I took the stuff over to storage in Texas and Dallas.
In 2 miles, take my 35 BR.
That's that situation. It's gonna allow me now to be able to pretty much find a house easier because I've been looking. That's that CB. I've been renting cars every weekend, and that's kind of tough, man. It's not the price that's bad because they're only used like $30 for a day. It's just the can't get the car until about 10, and then. You know, a lot of people close around 2 on Saturday. So now I'll be able to look on Friday evening when I get in, all day Saturday, and a lot on Sunday. So we're good to go on that front. But I have a bike down there, State Trooper. They've been busy. This is Blitz, DOT Blitz Week, where they're doing a lot of inspections. Y'all see, I'm getting all these cars getting on. I get over, get out of the way, give them space to merge. I'm about to get off in a mile here, so I'm going to go ahead and back it down and let them go. And get back to the right here. Let's go. I tell you, cars get on the highway. The speed limit is 70 out here for cars. And they just drive so slow, they merge at 40 and then expect you to move. It's crazy. I don't know. Legally, you're supposed to maintain your lane. You don't have to merge. Like, you don't have to get over. If I just stay in the right lane and they just want to go 40 and ride beside me and run off the road, that's on them. But as a professional driver,
take my 35 BR and then turn left in 0.7 miles.
As a professional driver, you know, you shouldn't be doing things like that, you know. You gotta not only drive for yourself, but defensively drive for others as well. But some people, they need all the help they can get. Just put it like that. But What was I talking about?
In 1,000 feet, oh, take I-35BR, and
I've
then turn
like
left at 0.7 miles.
Way more than what I've ever done. And they've all been open, all the way from Dallas all the way down here. Speed 35, back it down. I try to go a little bit under the ramp speed. This was not curved, so especially if you're going around curves on a ramp, definitely back it down.
In a half mile, prime turn left
like 10
on
to 15
East Man miles
Road. An hour below. But anyway, the DOT has been out today. I've been clenched all day. I just don't want to. I'd pass the inspection, but I just don't want the headache, you know. Some cops can be difficult, let's put it like that. You know how that goes. You meet that one cop that's had a bad day, and you know, let's say a brake adjustment, you know, one person might look at a brake adjustment
in a quarter
and
mile,
might look
turn
at it
left
and say it's
on
okay,
East
the other
Man
one,
Road,
it's
and
like,
then
oh, it's
turn left
a fraction of a hair
feet.
Off. You know, they write that up, that's CSA points, so I don't want that. They might
in
not give you a fine,
feet,
but
turn
even
left
warnings
on
count
East
the
Man
CSA
Road,
points.
And then turn left in 350 feet.
Right lane to make our left turn. Both lanes are turning left here. When you're making left turns like this, when there's two lanes going the same way, you want to be on the right lane. That way you give the cars space because your trailer's going to off-track into that lane if you don't turn wide enough. And if you go into the inside lane, it's not going to be enough room. Especially with these spread axles. So that they off-track even more than a like a tandem axle reefer. You got to be careful of that. And notice I'm not all in this car's like rear end, so don't be pulling up all close into people. But ready to get this over with, pull in, get my post trip done. And there's a Buffalo Wild Wings, you're gonna see it when we turn it after this post trip. We can go off duty, we can go eat some dinner, and come back and get some sleep work time. So we can get up in the first thing in the morning and unsecure this load, untarp it. Not gonna tarp it tonight. I see some clouds in the Doppler, not sure if it's gonna rain or not. I got some particle board on the deck, so don't wanna ruin the particle board. This particular count, like we do several of these loads a day, so I think it's maybe anywhere from like 10 to 15. I generally, when I'm making lefts like this, I try to look in this left lane to see if there's a car there and to see if they're kind of making this common sense decisions as far as getting out of the way. So you stay to the outside. I'm going to go ahead
and
go left.
In 300 feet, turn left on I-35 north.
There's a turn lane in, like Texas has over there, but I don't take it. Not this one coming, because I've been here several times. But this particular turn lane is really tight, especially for trucks. Try to avoid that one. Some of them are pretty big though. I noticed one over in Amarillo, a receiver
approaching
that I go
destination
to.
Destination in a quarter mile.
I
on
tried
the
to
right
make
side.
That thing. I had to back up out of it. It was pretty bad. I thought it was bigger than what it was. So. We all see B-dubs. I don't know if you see it. The first time I came here, I turned in this driveway right here, and that was a mistake, an absolute mistake, because you go, when you go in that driveway. Go into like the car parking lot, and they got all the little medians in the islands. Not good. Don't want to be in there. So I've learned to.
You have arrived at your
down.
Destination
Pass
on the
store,
right side, 6623
nice
Santerio
nice
Avenue.
Big right here. Nice and wide turn. I don't like hitting curves. You always gotta make sure you're checking traffic though. Don't just go willy-nilly turning. Hopefully I'm the only truck and I'm the first one back here. We'll find out. The last time I came here, I went and pulled it out of the back of the store and this other truck came flying around behind me. So I know some of the guys deliver like directly from across the border here. I think they're still open. Yeah, they are. But can't get unloaded. Some of the place stores, I'm not gonna tell you the name, you might have seen it, I don't know. Some of the stores we go to like this, downshift. Some of the stores we go to like this, they unload as played as you get there, as long as the store's open. But this one, they're really anal. Really anal. They only unload between 7 and like 10 in the morning, so. But we're the only ones here. We're gonna sleep back here. They've got like no parking, no truck parking signs. But as long as like you got a bill of lading that says this is your receiver, this is considered like a safe haven. You can park here, it's okay. Police try to hassle you. You know, you're not trespassing, you're not just here for no reason, so. Obviously don't park in a fire lane, but we're gonna go all the way to the end, is where they do the unloading. The first time I came here, I parked on the other end the opposite way, but now I've kind of learned where they want you, so. I'm glad the city's not out here. Last time I come out here, the city was doing work. Shut down right here. Well, I hope you guys had a good day today. I'm gonna try to start doing, like, probably more than likely some Sam. Hey, he's awake. Truck stops, he always wakes up. So you see, I'm letting the truck run a minute. I always kind of let my turbo cool down because the turbo is kind of like almost like a fan, if you will. If that makes sense. And imagine it spinning when you're driving, and oil like goes through it. And like when you're driving, so when you stop driving, oil stop going through, like if I just turn the truck off, but the fan's gonna keep going. And you don't want it to keep going with no oil going through. So I kind of give it a minute or two. It's actually recommended in the Freightliner book to do that. You're not supposed to, a lot of people say, don't idle this, don't idle that, which I don't consider this idling. This is a cool down for the truck, for the turbo. But warm-ups are not necessary. I do a couple minutes of cool down for my turbo, because I don't wanna mess it up. But I forgot what I was. I'm having a lot of moments of forgetting. Man, I'm tired. But what was I saying about the videos? I'm probably gonna end up just having to shoot. I'm trying to work out a rhythm here with these videos to get some better videos. So a lot of my loads are redundant, and I know you guys don't want to see redundant securement videos because it kind of gets boring after a while. But you know, you just like doing some of these vlogs. I don't really have time to. Make a video, edit that video, get sleep, wake up. I be banging these loads out like every day. You know, I go pick up, like I'm gonna leave here in the morning, go right down the road probably. There's got a place down here 12 miles away, reload, and shoot back north. I'm gonna say we're going to Amarillo tomorrow. I'm just gonna be presumptive with that and say we're gonna go to Amarillo. I don't know, maybe. Tomorrow's Thursday, so probably have a load going back up north and then reload on Thursday. No. Oh. I don't know, actually. Because I started this week kind of late. On Wednesdays, I'm usually up north delivering and then come back south on the Thursday for Friday and then reload on Friday and go back north to Dallas. I don't know what's going to happen. It's kind of backwards. We'll see. I was contemplating running the weekend since I missed a day because I didn't have a load yesterday. So, because I had to take off to get that car back. But we'll see. We'll see. Hopefully it works out. Like, subscribe, and share the video. I will catch you guys tomorrow. I'm going to get this post-trip going. He's going to do a thorough post-trip, extra thorough, because the DOT's watching. So I'm going to go over every nook and cranny more than so before. So, and I don't even know if that's possible, because I do a pretty thorough pre- and post-trip. But we'll try. I don't know. Maybe we'll do two of them. We'll let Sam do one. You want to do one, Sam? Oh, he's just staring at me. But you guys have a good night, and I will catch you later.